I'm Jeff Bowler, Program Manager in the Intune product group, and this session is Intune for Education Setup and Configuration. Let's talk about some requirements for Intune for Education. There are some subscriptions that you need. The first is Intune for Education, of course, and then also Office 365 for Education. From a device platform perspective, you need Windows 10, version 1703 or above, and then there's some Azure Active Directory tools that are optional. The first is School Data Sync, which integrates information from your school information system into Azure Active Directory. And then there's Azure Active Directory Connect, which synchronizes your users and groups from your on-prem Active Directory environment to Azure Active Directory. And then there's some bulk enrollment tools. First is set up school PCs, and that's designed specifically for schools. And the other is Windows Configuration Designer. Now, if you don't have today an Intune for Education tenant, you can create a trial subscription. I have on this slide links to where you can create trial subscriptions for Intune for Education and also Office 365 for Education. Now let's take a look at what the process is for adding these trial subscriptions. Here we are in the Intune for Education main website that provides information about Intune for Education, but also provides the option to start a free trial. So we're going to select this button, Start a Free Trial. So here we're presented with a form to fill out for the trial. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to pick our country. And in this case, we're going to pick United States. And then we're going to provide a name. A business address. Phone number, and a company name. And then also organizational size. In this case, we're just going to pick one person. We'll select Next. And then we're going to provide a username and a domain name that we can choose. And we'll see if that domain name is available, and it is. And we'll create a password. And then select Create My Account. Here I'm going to go ahead and enter my phone number so that they can send me a text. And I'll enter my text code that I received from Intune for Education. And now I'm ready to go. My trial has been created. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to create a trial subscription for Office 365. I'm going to go to the Office 365 website. Here we are in the Office 365 for Education website, which provides more information about Office 365 for Education and also allows us to create a subscription. I'm going to select IT Pros, sign up for your entire school. So then the next screen is presenting us with a Get Started for Free. And so I'll select Get Started for Free. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to select Yes, Add My Account. Since we just created the Intune for Education subscription, I'm going to go ahead and add this Office 365 subscription to that. Confirm my order. Select Try Now. Continue. And now I've created my Intune for Education trial subscription and Office 365 for Education subscription. Now let's go back to the slides. Now let's take a look at groups. Now, a group in Intune for Education is a collection of devices or users, and groups are used to assign apps and settings to devices and users. When you first create an Intune for Education tenant, it automatically creates two groups. It creates an all devices group and in all users groups. Now you have the ability to create additional groups in the Intune for Education portal, and then you can further organize these groups by creating subgroups. Now you can create subgroups in any group except for the all devices and all users groups. Now let's take a look at viewing and adding groups. We're going to start in the Office 365 Admin Center. As you can see, we already have some users that have been added into Azure Active Directory and can be used for Intune for Education. I'm going to go ahead and just search for a user. and click on this user to see some more detailed information about this user. And we can see that the user's email address, the product licenses that this user has, Intune for Education and Office 365 Education for Faculty. So Jess is a teacher. She's a standard user and she belongs to the all user groups. So that's good information to know. But let's go ahead and add a new user. So we'll simply click Add the User. And the student name will be student22. And this username will be the same. And we'll stay with this domain, ralphmill.edu. We'll keep the password auto-generated, and we'll keep the role as a standard user. But we will be assigning some product licenses. And the first product license we'll assign is Intune for Education. And the second license we'll add is Office 365 Education for Students. And once we've done that, we have all the configuration that we want for this user, and we'll click Add. And this user was added. Now the next thing we want to do is actually create a group. So I'll select Groups. Again, we can search for groups, but we're going to add a new group. And this group type is going to be a security group. The name is going to be Grade 7. And we'll add it. Now, I'm going to search for Grade 7. And select it. And as you can see, we don't have any members of Grade 7 right now. We'll edit that, select all members, and we're going to add a member. And we'll add student 22, which we just added, and save. Now student 22 is a member of Grade 7 group. So that is just a quick demonstration of adding users, viewing users, adding groups, viewing groups in the Office 365 Admin Center. But we can add groups also in the Intune for Education portal. So let's take a look at that. So here we are in the Intune for Education portal, and we'll select the Groups menu item. And here you can see, under Groups, a listing of different groups. We mentioned that, by default, all devices and all users are created. We also have all teachers and students and some additional groups. Now remember the group that we just created, Grade 7, and we did that in the Office 365 Admin Center. It's showing up here. And what we can do is we can select that group, and we can view the users that are a member of that group, and there is student 22. That's the student that we added and then also made a member of Grade 7. Now you do have the ability to add groups in Intune for Education portal, and it's very simple. I just select Create Group, and in this case, we'll say Grade 8. Select Create Group, and Grade 8 is created. Now we can also create a subgroup, and that's very easy. I can just click on Create Subgroup, and we can just say Math Class, and select Create Group. And I have a subgroup to Grade 8. Now, if I wanted to add a user to the Math Class, I can simply go to Edit Membership for Users, and I can search for a user. And I'm going to select student 21 and add users and then click OK. And now student 21 is a member of the math class. Okay, that gives you a demonstration of viewing and adding users and groups both in Office 365 and also in the Intune for Education portal. Now let's go back to our slides. I've provided some additional information on managing groups in Intune for Education and School DataSync and Azure Active Directory in the slides. Now this concludes the session on Intune for Education, Setup, and Configuration.